Good evening.
Hello.
Hi,
Hello. Okay, people. Bien. Good evening, people. Creo que 5. Todavía les falta terminar la unidad 4. Y 10, el examen final. Okay, vamos mejorando. Nos falta todavía. Tenemos hoy y mañana. Okay. We're about to start. Let me see the attendance.
Good evening.
Good evening. Okay. Let's see. Okay, I'm going to take the first attendance. So please respond, saying present, and turn on your cameras, okay? Alberto José Hernández. Not here. Amílcar Edenilson González.
Present.
Okay. Carlos Josué Hernández. Not today. David Alberto Rivera, not anymore. David Otoniel Martínez.
Presente.
Okay. Fidel Ángel Aguilera. Not yet. Gabriel Alonso Ponce. Not yet. Gerson Orlando Deodanes.
Present.
Okay. Iván Alberto Castillo. No. José Osvaldo Valle.
Present.
Okay. María José Portillo. María Julia Ramos.
Present, teacher.
Good. Marnie Betsaida Hernández.
Present.
Okay, Miguel Ángel Romero.
Present.
Good. Rafael Antonio, no, Patricio Noemí Guirao, not anymore. Rafael Antonio Martínez.
Present, teacher.
Okay, Rodolfo Alexander Fernández. Stephanie Janet Flores.
Present.
Okay. Víctor Antonio Benítez. Víctor Manuel Avilés. Okay. Well, last class, I gave you an exercise to practice the, to learn about the adjectives and their opposites. Let's see. I'm sorry. Okay. Can you tell me the pairs? Can you give me the pairs? Puedes darme los pares. Let's see. This one. What is this? ¿Hicieron esto o no lo hicieron?
Yes, teacher.
No, teacher.
One say yes, others say no. Okay, I will give you a few minutes to do it, to practice, to complete it. Aquí les pongo de nuevo el link en el chat.
Buenas noches, chicos. Dejarlo mañana porque tengo sueño. Sí, que buenas noches. Las quiero mucho. Solo dejar los chuchos.
What? Ahí les dejo el link. Les voy a dar unos minutos para hacerlo entonces. Let me send you to work in groups. Okay, go to your groups, complete that exercise, the adjectives and their opposites, and see you in 10 minutes.
El ángel es bueno.
Ajá.
Sí, el ángel.
El bad de sería el... Bad, ajá, bad.
Es Bad Bunny.
Por ejemplo, Harry, ¿cuál sería?
Eso es como difícil, ¿no? Algo así. Pesado, pesado. No sé.
¿Será aquí? Digo yo.
Pues.
Que lo está dominando.
Es lo único, lógico.
Y el opuesto de heavy.
Full light, ¿no? Easy, ¿no? Easy. Ajá, fácil.
Light es como luz.
Y full, ¿qué es full?
Full, lleno.
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 Cuando me alegro.
Ay,
cuando...
Yeah.
Los perritos.
Ajá, leía el perrito.
Y el opuesto de full.
Sería como vacío, pero no sé cuál. Ese sí no sé cómo se dice.
Empty, ¿qué es?
Empty.
Empty.
En
Devil de
with
de Devil debería
number one with ajá number one
vaya este sería
Devil
difficult empathy easy heavy
Okay, let's check together. Okay. What's this? Tell me the adjective, please.
We.
We.
This one?
Yes.
Okay. The opposite?
Dry.
Dry.
Yes.
Dry.
What's this?
Slow.
Slow.
Slow. Slow.
The opposite?
Fast.
Fast.
Fast. What's this?
Hard.
Huh?
No sé cómo se pronuncia la palabra.
Rich.
Rich.
Yeah.
Rich.
Rich.
The opposite?
Derecha.
Poor.
Poor. What's this?
Strong.
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 The opposite?
Weak.
Weak. What's this?
Hot.
Hot.
Hot. The opposite?
Cold.
Cold. Cold. Okay. What's this?
Sad. Not happy.
Happy. The opposite?
Sad.
Sad.
Sad. What's this?
Tall.
Tall.
Tall. The opposite?
Short.
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 What's this?
Small.
Small.
Small. The opposite?
Big.
Yes, big.
Oh, big.
What's this?
Young. Young.
Young.
Young.
The opposite?
Young.
Oh. Oh.
Oh.
Oh.
What's this?
Easy.
Easy. The opposite?
Difficult.
Difficult.
Difficult. What's this?
Good.
Good. The opposite?
Bad.
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 What's this?
Heavy.
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 The opposite?
Light.
Light.
Light. What's this?
Full.
Empty.
Full. Full. Opposite?
Empty.
Empty.
Empty. Empty.
What's this?
Thing. What?
Fat.
Fat. The opposite?
Thing.
Thing. Thing. Hey. Let's check. Everything is perfect. 10 out of 10. Very good. Let me record the pronunciation of these adjectives for you. Okay, I'm going to record it here. So listen. Wet, dry, slow, fast, slow,
fast,
rich,
rich,
poor,
poor,
strong, weak, hot, cold, happy, sad, tall, short, small, big, young, old, easy, difficult, good, bad, heavy, light, full, empty, fat, thin. Okay? Now you can practice later, okay? Any question with these adjectives? No question? ¿Todos entienden qué significa?
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Entonces, vamos a ver. Me van a escribir 5 oraciones cada uno. Usando los dibujos. En esta forma, como hemos aprendido. Por ejemplo, vaya, yo voy a hacer esta. Por ejemplo, he is a wet man. They are a dry couple. Una pareja. ¿Ya? Recuerden que debemos colocar para esta práctica the adjective first, primero the adjective y después el noun. Primero the adjective y después el nombre o sustantivo. ¿Ok? Va, 5 parejas así me van a hacer. ¿Ya? Por ejemplo, si estamos hablando de cosas o animales, vamos a decir, it is a slow snail. Es un caracol lento. Y la otra sería, it is a fast bird, es un pájaro rápido. ¿Ok? A ver, quizás sean muchos 5, solo háganme 3 pares. ¿Está claro? A ver. Sí. When you finish, please raise your virtual hand. Bien, veo que ya cuatro terminaron. Okay, I'm going to put you in small groups so you can share your sentences, okay? Go to your groups and share, compartan, share your sentences. Okay, I'd like to hear some of your sentences. Please, let's start with Rafael.
Leo mis oraciones, teacher.
Just two. Only two.
We are happy in English class. We are sad because tomorrow is finished the class, English class.
Okay, okay. Okay, Jose.
First, they are good people. The second, that it's a bad dog.
Okay, Ivan.
It is a slow tortoise. It is a fat cat.
Okay. Herson.
He is a happy jam. He is a sad jam.
Happy?
Happy jam.
Okay.
He's a sub John.
Okay, Miguel.
I'm happy with a full tank. And second, my wallet is empty. I don't have money.
Okay. Stephanie?
He is a strong boy. He is a good man.
Okay. Gabriel?
Okay. He is a very strong man. He is a very good person.
Okay. Marnie?
Jose is tough. My grandmother is small.
Mm-hmm. Ivan? Ivan?
That is big house. The car is small.
Okay, Carlos? Milcar.
Yo voy viniendo, teacher, que venía en el bus y la señora tenía más. Sí,
María Julia. María Julia.
Aquí estoy. She is a rich woman. He is a poor man.
Okay. Okay, bien. Incluso como vieron algunos ejercicios, ¿verdad? No siempre el adjetivo va a ir antes del nombre. Ya. Por ejemplo, si alguien dijo, my cat is fat. Correcto. Mi gato es gordo. It is a fat cat. Es un gato gordo. So hay diferentes maneras de decirlo. Ok. Ok, very good. Let's take the second attendance of the night. So please respond. Alberto José Hernández, not here. Amílcar de Nilson González.
Present.
Okay, Carlos Josué Hernández.
Presente, teacher.
Good. David Alberto Rivera, no. David Otoniel Martínez. Veo por ahí. Fidel Ángel Aguilera, not today. Gabriel Alonso Ponce.
Present.
Okay, Gerson Orlando Deodanes.
Present.
Okay. Iván Alberto Castillo.
Present.
Good. José Osvaldo Valle.
Here, teacher.
Okay. María José Portillo, no. María Julia Ramos.
Present, teacher.
Good. Marnie Betside Hernández.
Present.
Okay. Miguel Ángel Romero.
Present.
Good. Patricia Noemi Grau, no. Rafael Antonio Martínez.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Rodolfo Alexander Fernández. Not anymore. Stephanie Janet Flores.
Present.
Okay. Víctor Antonio Benítez. Y Víctor Manuel Aviles. Okay. Let's see what we have now. Next lesson, we'll be able to tell someone directions of where my workplace and someone else's are located. Okay. So we are going to learn how to give directions. Okay, directions. Look at this information about this employee. His name is Mauricio Quintanilla. His office phone number, it is 7203-9164. 7203-9164. The workplace, Arrows Technology Company. The address, Roosevelt Street and First Avenue, number 853, Santa Cecilia, San Salvador. Job position, software designer. Department, production. ID, MQ108359. Okay, there are four sentences here. Okay, we have to go back to the map on page 39 to respond these sentences with true or false. Okay, I want you to respond these sentences with true or false. But you have to look at the map on page 39. See page 39, this map. Okay. This map. We are talking about Arrows Company. Yeah. Page 45. So. Look in the map on page 39. You have to decide. Tienen que decirme si estas oraciones son true or false. Okay. So number one, dice, it is located in front of the mall on First Avenue. Let's see, the address is Roosevelt Street and First Avenue. Veamos si está enfrente del mall. ¿Está enfrente del mall? Yes or no?
Yes.
No.
Ah, no, a la par.
Okay. Arrows Company está aquí. El mall. ¿Está enfrente? No, right? It is located in front of the mall on First Avenue? No. That is false. Number one is false. Number two, it is located across First Avenue behind the restaurant. Yeah. It is located across First Avenue behind the restaurant.
True.
Está cruzando la First Avenue detrás del restaurante. Maybe.
Sí. No.
Sí, lo que pasa es que aquí no sabemos cuál es la entrada del restaurante. La entrada del restaurante fuera aquí.
Ahí sí.
Sí, ¿verdad?
Uh-huh.
Asumamos que esta es. Que está cruzando la First Avenue, across the First Avenue, behind the restaurant.
Digamos que es verdadero.
Luego dice, it is located on Roosevelt Street between the restaurant and Bookworm. It is located on Roosevelt Street between the Bookworm and the restaurant.
Yes.
Medio. Yes. ¿Verdad? Entre el restaurant y la bookworm. Yes. Es cierto. Digamos que sí. Y por último, it is located along Roosevelt Street next to the City Hall and the park. Está a lo largo de la Roosevelt Street next to a la par de the City Hall and the park.
No.
Along Roosevelt Street? Yes. Next to the City Hall? No.
No.
Next to the park?
Yes.
No, eso no sería next to. Next to sería esto. A la par. Pero aquí no está a la par. Hay una calle en medio. So, number four is false. Entonces, look at this. We have these words. In front of. Across.
Between.
Between.
Next to.
Next to.
Long.
Along. Okay. What are these? ¿Qué son estas? Bueno, también son prepositions of place. Son más preposiciones de lugar. Ya habíamos visto al 3. ¿Cuáles habíamos visto? What preposition of place? Ya vimos.
Between.
No.
In, plus, on, at.
In, on, at.
Across.
Estas son las que ya vimos anteriormente. Aquí hay más. Among. In front of. Near. Past. Look at this question. Where is the park located? ¿Dónde está ubicado? Where is the park located? It is located among many places. Among many places. Among is entre, entre, pero no de en medio. ¿Verdad? No necesariamente entre en medio de, pero no, no que solo haya dos cosas, sino entre varias cosas. Por eso dice among many places. ¿Ya? O sea, no es lo mismo among que between. Between tiene que ver con solamente, digamos, aquí está algo, aquí está el otro, y aquí está el otro. Aquí sí diríamos between. ¿Ya? Acá. Esto estaría between, en medio de dos cosas, de dos lugares, medio. ¿Ya? Hay uno a la izquierda, el otro a la derecha. Between. Pero este en medio de, entre, es entre muchas cosas. ¿Ya? O sea, por ejemplo, la libreta está entre todos esos libros. ¿Me explico? Ese tipo de entre, ese tipo en medio de, es among. ¿Ya? Es diferente del between. Luego, in front of. Where is the Sport Palace located? It's located on Barrios Street in front of the park. In front of. Where is the mall located? It's located near the restaurant. Near. Cerca de. Where is the church? It's located past the school. Past. Pasando después de past the school. Okay. We have more prepositions here. Along, in front of, behind, next to, between, across, past, yonder. Let me see if I have a picture to show you this. Give me a second. Let me show you with this picture. Give me a second. Okay, here. Let me show you this picture. Okay, more prepositions of place, okay? Ya les comparto esta imagen, ¿no? So we have this picture behind. So the ball is behind the block or the box or the block. The ball is behind, in front of, next to, between, near, okay, cerca, above,
arriba.
Uh-huh. Look, it's above is different from on. On is when they are in contact. So the ball is on the block. Yeah, but there is contact between the ball and the block. You know? But here it is above. There is no contact. You see the difference between above and on? Yes? Below. Below. In. In. Okay, look at these examples. The dogs are behind the postman. The dogs are behind the postman. The dog is in front of the man. The dog is in front of the man. The dog is next to the bones. Next to or beside. They are similar. Next to or beside. The bone is between the two dogs. Between the two dogs. The dog is near the book. Near the book or close to. Near the book or close to the book. Similar. The blue dog is above the fire hydrant, above or over, We can use above or over. The fire hydrant is below the blue dog or under the blue dog. Below or under. The hydrant is below or under the blue dog. In, the dog is in the bed. There is a thermometer in its mouth. In. And finally, the dog is on the table. The woman has saliva on her. So these are more prepositions of place. Any question with these prepositions? Are they clear? ¿Están claras?
No, teacher, I confused about behind.
Behind. Look, the dogs are not in, it, behind is the opposite of in front.
Okay, I understand.
Okay. Any other question? No? Perfect. Let me share this picture with you. Okay. Now let me give you another exercise to practice. Give me a second. Give me a moment. I don't know what's going on here. Okay. Oh, yeah. Okay, go to this link. The exercise is this. Look at this map. This little map. We have different places here. Main Street, Maple Street, Davis Street. We have a bank, Chinese restaurant, a library, a bus stop, park, a cinema, a supermarket, a parking lot, an art gallery, a museum, a swimming pool, a hospital, a flower shop, a hotel, a bakery, a toy shop, a payphone, a police station, a mailbox, an Italian restaurant, a school, and a post office. Different places. So you have to make sentences with these words. For example, school, Italian restaurant. School, where is the school? School here, Italian restaurant here. The school is next to the Italian restaurant. The school is next to the Italian restaurant. Yeah? Basically, you're going to use these prepositions: in front of, next to, between, and behind. So complete the other sentences. Complete these sentences. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. When you finish, check your work here. Okay. Raise your hand when you finish, okay?
I don't understand.
Mira, es que me estoy tocando.
No, lo complica el animal.
¿Any question?
Where is it?
No questions, people?
Es con un chino restaurante, qué chido está. Me gusta porque ve, así. Ajá, entonces yo voy a tener que decir, ¿dónde está la librería? ¿Dónde está la galería de arte? ¿Dónde está el parqueo? Y voy a tener que decir, está a la par de la policía. Y está en su.
Están dando copia.
¿Así?
Anoten.
Chicos, ¿cómo van?
Hi, teacher. Yo tengo una duda. Porque la número, ya le digo, la número 4 me salió mala. Donde dice Bakery Hotel Toy Shop. Pero según el mapa se ve entre, ¿verdad?
Ajá.
No sé por qué me la marco como mala. Yo lo coloqué como between.
Ok, a ver qué.
No alcanzo a leer bien aquí. Voy a ver aquí. Dice, the bakery is between the hotel and toy shop.
Suena bien, is between the hotel and the toy shop.
A mí me salieron malas porque no le puse the hotel and
ajá.
Sí, de hecho estoy viendo, corroborando también de que sí, en Toy Shop no lo coloqué yo.
Eso debe ser.
Sí.
Ok, let's see. A ver, Miguel, write number 2, please. Toma el control and write number 2.
Ya me cachó haciendo trampa. Eso siempre, Miguel. Ey, no haga la bulla, viejo. Ey, mire, ya.
Ajá.
Así no se puede, teacher.
¿Por qué?
Aceptarlo, te dieron copia.
Solo que vos, viejo.
The cinema is in front of the toy shop. Okay. Voy a quitar este espacio de más para que no. Okay, good. Now, Stephanie, number 3. Y luego vamos a revisar. Okay, next would be Marnie. Number four. Okay. Oh. Number five. Jose. Okay. Next, number six. Rafael. Yeah, I'll say that. Okay. A ver. Carlos, number seven.
No, no lo he terminado, teacher.
Okay.
Rafa, teacher.
Okay, Rafael, number seven.
No me acuerdo dónde estaba el Museo del Arte, teacher.
¿El qué?
No me acuerdo dónde es que estaba. No me acuerdo del mapa.
¿Y? Suba, joven. Búsquelo.
Solo paja, barra.
Solo por eso que pase Miguel después, teacher.
Thank you. Okay. ¿Qué me falta?
Miguel tiene ganas de pasar otra vez.
¿Voluntario, voluntaria? Nadie. David.
Stephanie, veo que quiere, teacher.
Bueno, para pasar la pelota ustedes. Hey. No, no estamos buscando vuelos. Aquí estamos. No, pero ahí tenemos swimming pool y hospital. No tenemos art gallery. Bueno, voy a dejarlo así, pero no es eso. Revisemos pues lo que hicieron. One, two, three, four. The supermarket is behind the cinema. The museum. ¿Dónde está el museum?
Between the museum and hospital, teacher.
The swimming pool is between the museum and the hospital. Y era la última. Bueno. Okay. Para mañana piensen en lugares cerca de su lugar de trabajo, de su vivienda. Y unas cuantas oraciones acerca de lugares y su ubicación. ¿Ya? The supermarket está a la par de la farmacia o el parque está detrás de la iglesia, qué sé yo. Cosas así. ¿Ok? Ok, people. Mañana terminamos. Un par de cosas. Mañana. Bueno, vamos a. Tiene que estar ya la unidad 4. Y el examen final. Y creo que ya recibieron los datos de la encuesta. Mañana la vamos a hacer.
Okay.
¿Verdad? Si es que no la toquen, que mañana juntos tenemos que hacer esto. ¿Ok? Yeah. Vaya pues, voy a tomar la última asistencia. Alberto José Hernández, no llegó. Amílcar de Nilson González.
Present.
Ok, Carlos Josué Hernández.
Presente, teacher.
Ok, David Alberto Rivera, David Otoniel Martínez.
Presente.
Ok. Fidel Ángel Aguilera, no llegó. Gabriel Alonso Ponce.
Presente.
Ahí está. Gerson Orlando Deodanes.
Presente.
Ok, Iván Alberto Castillo. Fue. José Osvaldo Valle.
Presente.
Ok. María José Portillo, María Julia Ramos.
Present, teacher.
Ok, Marnie Betsaida Hernández.
Present.
Good, Miguel Ángel Romero.
Present.
Good, Patricia Noemí Guirao, Rafael Antonio Martínez.
Present, teacher.
Ok, Rodolfo Alexander Fernández and Stephanie Janet Flores.
Present.
Víctor Antonio Benítez y Víctor Manuel Avilés no llegaron. Okay, people, that's all for today. See you tomorrow. Complete unit 4 and the final exam. Y mañana hacemos la survey, la encuesta.
Good night, teacher.
Good night. Bye-bye. Bye,
teacher. Good night.
Bye, teacher. Bye. See you tomorrow.
Thank you. Okay, el estudiante que le tocaba hoy, pues no se hizo presente.